All right, yo, join us back for episode 2 of Free to Play with Channel Fireball, or on Channel Fireball, I should say. So, we left the last episode with a riveting last game. Make sure to go watch it if you haven't. So, just to recap our goals and what we are trying to do here, we are just trying to get to this deck here, which costs 500 coins, and are at the minute 460. So, hopefully, in this episode, we can get to the Dragonite deck. We can buy it, because at the minute, the deck we are having to play is trash. I do not like it. Mental Might. There's a lot of things wrong with this deck, to be honest with you. But yeah, it is a necessary evil. We have to play it. This is a deck that Pokemon gives you to play with. Let me just grab my bottle of water. Okay. So we always go Tails. That's the coin flip. So all we're trying to do in this episode is just get to the Dragonite deck as fast as possible. Our opponent lets us go far. Okay. So, I think our best lead here is Furfro, right? It's the basic Pokemon, 90 HP. We're going to do 50 damage and can paralysis. Can inflict paralysis with 2 energy. So, I mean, to be fair. Okay, so we have a simple turn. That's all we got to do. Next turn, we'll Tight Jaw. Now, this is a deck we could have played, I think. Do you get coins for playing against the computer? Oh my lord, I never even thought of that. Maybe you do. Anyway, PvP's fun. More fun. We hit with a tackle. Oh my goodness. Okay. Okay, we'll bench Mill Tank. Tight Jaw. Hopefully get ahead. Yeah, we do. Nice. So now they have to evolve to even attack us, which is pretty cool. Hopefully they haven't got it. Like I said, the theme deck battles, they ain't going to be the most entertaining. I'm not going to lie to you. Oh, hopefully they haven't got a way to switch. That walk could be annoying. But it's actually pretty riveting gameplay. Like I said, if you didn't see the last game, oh my goodness. That was a barrel of laughs. Okay, so now we get the Sharp Fang KO. It's what you like in theme deck battles. Having a big basic attack is sometimes just as good. Now, we are going to get hit with this roar, which makes us switch, right? So I think we go into Mill Tank and just start using Powerful Friends. Our opponent plays a Sycamore. That is a crazy supporter to have in the theme deck event. Being able to discard your hand and draw 7. I could only dream of draw power like that. But our opponent has all the stuff here. Wow. We could even just attach Retreat and go back into our Furfro. Could be an option. PXP share the active. It's not quite how it works. It's going to attach it back here. That's okay, though. They're trying their best. Okay, they go for the roar. Go into roll. So we'll just attach Retreat, right? No, we want to Yerno, I think. Okay, we'll roller skates, flip heads. Nice, draw 3. Okay, so we get Curlia. Just still has a 1 retreat cost, which is fine. We'll just attach. Retreat. Don't need to do anything else, I think. So we will just Sharp Fang. We could have maybe gone for the Tight Jaw flip heads there to stop them roaring again, but honestly, I think it's okay. Yeah, let me know what you think about this free to play series. You got any suggestions? Oh, a Lissandre. Back into that one. Should have went into this one. It's got 2 retreat costs. Yeah, let me know if you've got any suggestions for this series, by the way. Anything you want me to do? Maybe at some point we have a decent deck. Should we do some viewer battles, maybe? I don't know. I'll leave it up to you. I've never done something like this before. I mean, I'm finding it really fun, actually. As riveting as these... Oh, we have a Gallade now? Didn't even realize. Yeah, as riveting... Well, as much as I rib on these theme deck battles, right? It is kind of entertaining. Like, Hoothoo winning us the game last was crazy. So, and where, do you know what I like about these battles, actually? Is that it makes you appreciate... it makes you appreciate the other cards, right? Because, for example, like the deck I play right now for real life events, let me show you. It's as Mew VMAX, okay? This is a card in a deck. Hang on, let me get my face up. Yeah, this is a deck that can hit up to 300 damage, right, off 1 energy attachment. It's possible. So it makes all the rest of the trading. It makes like 90% of a Pokemon trading card game set pretty much obsolete. Yeah, you don't care. This is doing bonkers things. Whereas now, like in this format, 3 for 50 or 2 for 20 paralysis flip is insane. That's crazy. Okay. So I think all we do now, we can actually fan club to get our other mill tank. And I guess we take... Do we have another Corellia? Yeah, we do. I guess we take these two then. Then we'll just pay retreat. And then powerful man. Look at us fly now. This is the thing. Like, when the decks are working, it flies away. But it's just, unfortunately, it doesn't happen all the time. Okay. So now we're just going to powerful friends. Just keep powerful friends in. We didn't even bench that wall. That was a mistake. I meant to bench that. Lol. Too busy getting distracted. That is a burning energy. Nice. Damage to zero. That's the... No need to do anything else. We probably could have played that great ball, actually. Yeah, this is... This mill tank is a problem. Oh, an effective 130 HP Pokemon. This Combustion won't even do any damage because of our hard charm. That's gross, isn't it? That's gross. Like, a little bit of good sequencing here. Before we play our Great Ball, we're going to play the Professor's Letter to take cards that aren't Pokemon out of the deck, so we have more chances of hitting what we want off the Great Ball. Ideally, a Gallade. Okay. I guess we'll take... Delcati. Attached to this. Let's just potion that as well, because why not? Oh, we don't actually KO. We KO everything else, though. Yeah, okay. So what we'll do, we'll take a prize with Miltank, and then we'll try and one-shot this Moltres with Gallade. I think that's what we're trying to do. Okay. We go into this. Maybe powerful friends KO'd out. Oh, it's actually got the burning energy, but again, if they go for the combustion or the flying flare, they do 20 to themselves. So maybe powerful storm will be a KO. They go for the 120. So it's got 100 health left. 2, 4, 6, 8. Oh yeah, so we can take the KO with Gallade. So that play worked out really well. But I think this is a KO. Let me just make sure. Let me just get myself try and get another Gallade. We don't get it. Yeah, this should be a KO, right? Yeah. Okay, nice. So, let's see what we get off the ladder now for our reward. Hopefully, enough coins to get ourselves a Dragonite. I wouldn't mind a pack as well. So, we get... How many coins was that? 20. Okay. We get 20 coins. MVP Furfuro. Well done, Furfuro. 480. Okay, well, so we get one more win. Oh, wait. What's this going to give us? What's it? I thought I was going to give us something good. Okay. So, let's open that chest. Collection. I'm not even sure we can get in these. Packs. Oncoming reward chest. We just want some good stuff, really. Wait! I thought I was going to give us enough. A Grimmsnarl. That's trash. Okay, well, we will never be using that. Let me tell you that for free. Right, let's just get back into the PvP. One more win gets us the Dragonite deck, and that is what we want. I want that right now. Give it to me right now. The Dragonite deck. Don't know what you're thinking of. Let's see. Okay, we're playing against that same fire deck, which I don't think was that great, to be honest with you. Hopefully we just go first. Thank you. Hopefully we have a Corellia, a Ralts, Corellia, and Gallade in our open hand. Close. Yeah, I guess we lead mill tank. So worst case, we can just start hammering. Okay. Yeah, we are playing. Oh, we've got a Waltz and a Gallade actually. So if we can just wind Corellia, I'd be quite happy with that. But we'll bench this. We attach up there. Roller skates, go on, be heads. Very good. Okay, well, we can bench Srubat. Don't know if I want to bench that Waltz yet. So we'll just pass it over. If we had Rare Candy lets you go straight from the basic to the stage two. Really fun, actually. Steven, that's a really good card in the theme deck. Really good card. As you get a supporter and a basic energy. Oof, they've gone for Lissandre. Wow. Gonna try and stall us out, huh? Yeah.
Don't mind it. Ooh, curly off the top's naughty. I think what we might actually attach is there. Powerful friends, because next turn we'll have a powerful storm lined up. If they go into, then if they bring us up into that, we can just start heart stamping. I think I'm fine with that. They haven't even got a bench Pokemon. No, they can't really bench. What do they go into? They go into the curly, that's a mistake. That's a mistake. What does Rapidash do? That's ridiculous. That's crazy. We have to just heart stamp this thing then. Oh no. Gotta bench that. I still think we could be okay. Our opponent style hasn't done a lot. Hopefully they don't bench a Pokemon. That Lissandre play into the evolve with Fire Blast is crazy. Okay. Actually, we need to get energy cards off all things. How much have I got? 50. Okay, so we're gonna have to heart stamp again. Oh yeah, then finish off with a mill tank, right? Didn't get it back. Wow, look at the synergy. That's crazy. We get energy. Cool. Right, so that's Evo Soda. I guess we attach this here. So actually, heart stamp never KOs, right? No. So what I might do is go for the energy gift. Nice. 1, 2. Touch him down here. Because there's no point in going for the heart stamp again because it never KOs. So might as well get these energies into play, evolve into Galay, bap with this. And then I don't know what else they're going to do, to be honest with you. At that point, the war won't matter because we'll have two attackers online. But Lissandre again would be backbreaking, to be honest with you, but I doubt it has it. Okay. Good little synergy here though, right? So we go into that mill tank. So they just get this back. Okay, so now we have Gallade. We'll just powerful friends KO that. I want that win. I want that Dragonite deck. Give it to me. Throw a throw. The Dragonite deck. Give me the Dragonite deck. Not what you're thinking at home. Now they will always go into this and we just bop, right? This thing needs 4 energy, so I'm not really scared of that, to be honest with you. Make sure you go check out episode 1, by the way. That last game was crazy. Alright, so they roar. We're going to this. Great ball. Guess we take that just to thin the deck. We just swift lunge. We take one more prize card, get the double Golett. It's annoying because we get Golets in the deck. They don't even give you Golurk in this deck. It's so bad. So we want to probably... Do we want to switch to 2, 4, 6, 8? They hit us. We potion, hit them. No, we don't want to switch. Well, do we? Hold on, they hit us for 20. How much damage does this do? 80 plus 40, 120. Oh, do we survive actually? Okay, oh, it's chill, it's chill, it's chill, it's chill. That is actually interesting. 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so we're gonna have to do, touch this here, potion that. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So now, if they want to go for the big flying flare, they'll have to actually KO themselves, right? So if we swift lunge, that comes up. That can't do anything. They go to 3. Then we KO it. That comes up. Nah, we just powerful. It's annoying that we missed energy that one turn. So if we didn't miss energy, we actually would have had the KO there. But okay. I still think we're in a decent spot. Just trying to min-max, you know what I mean? Just trying to trying to min max. I want that Dragonite deck. I don't want to play any more silly games. I mean, to be fair, Dragonite deck's not exactly a free pass. It was still is a theme deck, but it's a very good deck. So now we have another energy. What I might do, attach this here. No, we don't have to. Remember, we don't have to leave our Gallade in any trouble, so we can always just powerful friends. And then if this Miltank gets killed, we can then use our Gallade to attack. That's my thinking. That's my thinking right there. I think it's correct. I don't know what the evolution is in this deck, or even if there is one. So a lot of the times there ain't. Oh, it's a Flareon. 90 HP. Oh, we don't 80. Two Sycamores. They played two, right? Was that the last game? Oh no, it was the last game. EXP share. Okay. I'm not just gonna steamroll this game, unfortunately. Power map, what are they prized? Scorched Earth. In the deck some more. Do we get KO to this? No. Nice. Okay. Because this does what? 80 on a coin flip and we have 90 health. Perfect. So unless they have another Giovanni, which would make me very sad if they did. Tails, very good. Do we want to heal this? Probably do, actually. So now we KO this. Bap. 160 damage in total. Oh my goodness. So now this has 60 health. It doesn't get KO to the Growlithe. I don't know what Arcanine does, if they have it. We've got a free card hand, actually. So I'm hoping they haven't got a ton of resources. One thing I'm worried about, just I never thought I'd be worried about in this deck, is we've really got a lot of energy going around, actually. We have not got a lot of energy rolling around. Okay, they're going to Growlithe. We do carry that. Please don't have an Arcanine. Can't be arsed. I want to just, let's just wrap this game up now. No, they don't. Okay. So we just carry this, go down to one, and then Galadriel wants to KO anything. Play Great Ball in the deck. So we just powerful friends, KO that. What music is this playing? I didn't think this was in this playlist. Put that on. Okay. Now they go into Eevee. We just KO this. We can't even get boss tools. We'll just retreat. This does 80. So unless they have another Flareon in hand, it has to be in hand as well, unless they got a supporter. This game should be wrapped up, I think. And that should give us the Dragonite theme deck, baby. Yes! Dragonite, let's go! It's powerful, friends. Oh, Mighty! What's this deck called again? Mental Might, let's go! Mental Might getting us a dub. That should be... Wait, is that enough? 30. That should be, right? That should be enough, I think. Yes, 590. Very good. Yes. Okay. All right, this theme deck is a lot better. Trust me. But 75 coins. Wow. We get two tournament tickets off this as well. Okay. So let's go buy that theme deck. Let me run you through this theme deck and why it's so good. And then let's have a look. So where is it? Dragonite. So we want to buy this. Confirm. All right, let's have a look. So why is this deck so good? It's built around this guy, Dragonite. So instead of having the Gallade, this is our sort of stage that we want to get into play. The once you so before you attack, you can attach a water and electric energy card from your hand to any one of your Pokemon. That's insane. Look at this attack as well. Four energy mon, 170. You put 300 on Gallade, you're an 80. So that's already better than Gallade in my opinion. Right. Then we even have a little bit of inbuilt consistency with Pidgeotto. Let you look at the top two cards of your deck. Put one in your hand, put onto the bottom. That is crazy card advantage. What collect here, which is really, this is like a hoot equivalent. This doesn't need energy. Crazy.
We've got this guy, which is always good for a KO at some point in the game. Because he's got like an inbuilt EXP share with its ability. So when something gets knocked out, you can move an energy to it. But what I think makes this deck really good is two big basic really good attackers, right? That don't need the stage two out. So Thunderous does 70 damage for two energy if you have Thunder Tornadus in play. And does 120 for three. And Tornadus does Thunderous Tornado 80 damage if Thunderous on your bench. Do 20 damage to all your opponent's Pokemon. That is crazy. So yeah, this, and it's got a lot more support as well. Cynthia, Howl, Lily, Fangclaw, Bugcatcher. Much, much, much better deck. So I'm going to wrap this episode up there. And the next episode, we're going to unleash some fury with Dragonite.